Hello students, we are going to discuss about bin profile and stack plume pattern. First we are going to discuss plumes. What is plume? Plumes are a mixture of both gases and particulate matter. Particulate matter is nothing but very small particle present in the atmosphere. Large particles have appreciable settling velocity and settle faster. Large particles having higher settling velocity, so that's why it goes to settle fast. Smaller particle tends to remain suspended in the atmosphere for longer period of time, and that dispersion or spreading behavior may be similar to that of gases. Very small particles. That behavior similar to that of gases. Diffusion is an important parameter in the dispersion of plume. What is diffusion? It is the net movement of anything from a region of higher concentration to an area of lower concentration. What is the examples of diffusion in day-to-day life? Heat from the body diffuses away in the form of sweat that evaporates. Another example, perfume. This is the diffusion. Then food coloring, tea. So these are the examples of diffusion. So here diffusion is an important parameter in the dispersion of plume. So plume height. How will we calculate the plume height? Plume height will determine the pollutant concentration measured at the ground level. Types of plume. Plume can be classified into two types. One is continuous plume, another one instantaneous plume. First one, continuous plume. Release and the sampling time are long compared with travel time. Example, smoke released from a stack. Instantaneous plume, release time and sampling time is short when compared with the travel time, buoyancy effect. Okay. A plume rise. This figure shows that plume rise. What is plume? Mixture of both gases and particulate matter. So this is rise in a vertical direction. So this is the plume rise. Plume rise will depend on the following factors. Temperature of the emission or emission temperature. Cross-sectional area of the stack. Emission velocity. Then horizontal wind speed. Finally vertical temperature gradient. Temperature gradient is nothing but vertically with respect to distance, how much temperature, that is dT by dx. These are the factors depends on plume rise. Higher the effective stack height, that is meaning effective stack height is higher, dispersion also higher. Effective stack height can be increased by building taller stack and emitting pollutant at a high temperature. Many large fossil fuel pollutant disperse their pollutant in this way. Their stack height 250 to 300 meters are commonly used. The few fossil fuel pollutant are 400 meters tall. What are fossil fuel? Coal, oil, natural gas, etc. Wind speed is higher, plume bend over and become transported downwind. Higher wind speed decreases the plume rise. Dispersion may not be affected adversely. Adversely means that is unfavorably. High wind enhances the dispersion process. It is not affected. Enhance the dispersion process. Plume rise is unfavorably affected by atmospheric stability. Atmospheric stability means whether the atmosphere is stable or unstable. Atmosphere becomes stable, that is inversion condition. Plume rise reduced. Dispersion is decreased. Result is higher ground level concentration downwind. Types of plume rise. Plume rise can be classified into two types. One is buoyancy effect. Second one, momentum rise. One by one we will discuss. First one, buoyancy effect. Plume rise due to the temperature difference between stack plume and ambient air. Ambient air is nothing but surrounding air. This is called buoyancy effect. Second one, momentum rise. What is momentum? Mass into velocity. Rise due to exit velocity of the effluent or emission velocity. This is called momentum rise. This is very important factor, dry adiabatic lapse rate. Rate at which dry air cools as it rises is called dry adiabatic lapse rate. This is independent of ambient air temperature, that is surrounding. Adiabatic means no heat exchange between rising air and ambient air. This is adiabatic condition. Ambient and dry adiabatic lapse rate. What is ambient lapse rate? Ambient lapse rate also called environmental lapse rate. It is a temperature change in the air per vertical distance. What is adiabatic lapse rate or dry adiabatic lapse rate? Rate at which dry air cool as it rises is called dry adiabatic lapse rate. It is independent of ambient air temperature, that is surrounding air temperature. Adiabatic means no heat exchange between rising air and ambient air. Relationship between ambient and dry adiabatic lapse rate determine the stability of air. Both are equal. Ambient lapse rate and dry adiabatic lapse rate, both are equal. Neutral stability. Super adiabatic. So the unstable and favorable dispersion. Sub adiabatic condition. Stable and the result is poor dispersion. Inversion. Extremely stable and the trap pollutant inhibiting dispersion. What is inversion? In meteorology, inversion also known as temperature inversion is a deviation from the normal change of an atmospheric property with altitude. Is it correct? It almost always refers to an inversion of the thermal lapse rate. Normally, air temperature decreases with the increase in altitude. Next, we are going to discuss plume shape and atmospheric stability. So here, four type of plume shapes are there. First one, looping plume, coning plume, fanning plume, fumigation. One by one we will discuss. First one, looping plume. It is a wavy character and occurs in super adiabatic environment. So environmental lapse rate is greater than adiabatic lapse rate, which produces highly unstable atmosphere because of rapid mixing. In an unstable atmosphere, rapid air movement takes place vertically, both upward and downward, and the plume becomes a looping plume. Second one, coning plume. In this plume occurs under essentially neutral stability. Environmental lapse rate is equal to adiabatic lapse rate. And a moderate to strong wind, the plume enlarges in the shape of a cone. This is called cone influence. Third one, fan influence. Pattern of smoke stack plume dispersion is a statically stable atmosphere. Stable atmosphere means weak vertical mixing, in which the plume spread out in the horizontal, like on oriental fan and meanders, about at a fixed height with a little vertical spread. Why? Because already I said stable atmosphere, weak vertical mixing. Unstable atmosphere, strong vertical mixing. Last one, fumigation plume. It causes the high polluting concentration plume reaching the ground level along the length of the plume, and is caused by a super adiabatic lapse rate, based on inversion or thermal lapse rate. The super adiabatic lapse rate at the ground level occurs due to the solar heating. This condition mostly favorable by clear sky and light wind. These are the plume shapes and atmospheric stability. So plume shapes are four types. First one, looping plume. Second one, coney plume. Third one, fanny plume. Last one, fumigation. So the first one, our first figure indicate looping plume. What is looping plume here? It is a wavy character. Are clear? Okay. So it is a wavy character. You see this. So this is the wavy. So then it is occurs super adiabatic environment. In left hand side you see that. So here in this graph, super adiabatic. Why? Because environmental lapse rate is greater than adiabatic lapse rate. So this is super adiabatic environment. Are you clear? So which produce highly unstable atmosphere. Why? Because unstable is a strong vertical mixing. So this is going like this. This is in a vertical way. So the highly unstable because of rapid mixing. In an unstable atmosphere, rapid air movement takes place vertically, both upward and downward. This is very important. Both upward and downward, this plume is called looping plume. Are you clear? So this figure clearly indicates looping plume. So both upward and downward. Are you clear? Yes. Second one. Second type, coning plume. Coning plume, the figures indicate the essentially neutral stability. Environmental lapse rate is equal to adiabatic lapse rate. In left hand side, the graph indicates adiabatic. So this is equal neutral stability. So this is moderate to strong wind. So you see the figure, the coney flow. So this figure indicates coney flow. This is moderate to strong wind. So this flow enlarges in the shape of cone. You see in this picture, so this figure like a cone. So that's why this is the coning plume. Third one, fanning plume. So in fanning plume is nothing but, so here a pattern of smoke stack plume dispersion in a statically stable atmosphere. You see this figure. So the fanning plume, the stable atmosphere. Stable means there is a weak vertical, no vertical, in a horizontal direction. So the plume spread out in a horizontal like on oriental fan and meanders about at a fixed height with a little vertical speed. So practically this is no vertical. So here this is the horizontal direction. So you see in the left hand side, the graph indicates inversion. So this is due to the inversion. So this is the temperature variation. The inversion generally there is a temperature variation. So here fanning plume, you see a figure rightly indicate. So this is no vertical, this is the horizontal direction. Last one, fumigation. The fumigation is nothing but it causes the high pollutant concentration plume reaching the ground level. You see this figure. These plumes goes to ground level. So along the length of the plume, and is caused by superadiabatic lapse rate beneath on inversion. So you see in the left hand side, in this graph, inversion over superadiabatic. The superadiabatic lapse rate at the ground level occurs due to what? Solar heating. So this condition, this fumigation plume condition, most favorable by clear sky and light wind. So these are the plume shape and atmospheric stability. This is effective stack height calculation. Final height of the plume is called effective stack height. So capital H is equal to Hs plus delta H. What is Hs? Physical stack height. Delta H is nothing but plume rise. Plume rise is calculated from the imaginary center line of the plume. Plume rise depends upon the stack physical characteristics and on the effluent characteristics. Effluent characteristics is nothing but stack gas or flue gases. Carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide, these are the stack gas. Difference in temperature, that is delta T, is equal to stack gas TS minus ambient temperature TA. This is a difference in temperature delta T. Gives the plume density which affects plume rise. Velocity of the stack gases is a function of the stack diameter and the volumetric flow rate per hour, how much metric cube of gases are flowing. Of the extracted gases determine the plume's momentum. Plume's momentum is nothing but noise into velocity. This is the picture of effective stack height calculation. You see in this figure. So capital H. What is the capital H? Effective stack height. Effective stack height formula, capital H is equal to Hs plus delta H. What is the Hs here? Hs is a physical stack height. Are you clear? Delta H is nothing but plume rise. How much plume rise? That is the height. How much height plume rise? Delta H. Capital H is equal to Hs plus delta H. So from this figure, capital H is equal to effective stack height. Hs is equal to physical stack height. Delta H is equal to plume rise. Are you clear? Yes. So here, what is the TS? TS is nothing but stack gas. Stack gas temperature. What are the stock gases? Carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide. These are the flue gas or stack gas. Then this is the center line. The center line or imaginary center line. So plume rise is calculated from the imaginary center line of the plume. This is the delta H. Delta H is calculated from the imaginary center line of the plume. Delta H is nothing but plume rise. Are you clear enough? Okay. So here, change in temperature, delta T is equal to TS minus TA. Which one is the TS? TS is the stack gas temperature. TA is nothing but ambient air temperature. Are you clear? Now we are going to discuss about wind profile, the variation of horizontal wind speed and direction with a height are important in evaluating the diffusion from stack. Wind profile exponent to play an important role in air pollution management study. Atmospheric layer close to the earth influence that drag due to the earth surface, affecting parameter like wind speed, turbulence and temperature. Different wind profile exponent are in use in various air dispersion model for estimating wind strength at the height of the pollutant release. Thank you for your attention.